Hey guys, Teacher Lauren here. I am in the process of redoing one of my videos because I realized the audio is horrible. And I am so sorry for that. I'm hoping this one turns out a lot better. I'm coming to you tonight to tell you what do you need to teach with VIPKID. And that is for anybody that has just been hired, anybody that's in the middle of the application process or interviewing, or somebody that might be interested in applying to VIPKID. And if you are interested in applying to VIPKID or you do not have a referrer on your application, make sure you check out my referral link and referral code in the description box of this video so that I can help you through the process. Now, they no longer tell us your email address so we can contact you to help you. So if you do use that, please reach out to me at my email, which is VIPKIDTeacherLauren, B-E-J, at gmail.com. So that way I can help you. Just send me an email that says, hey, I just applied under you. Please and I am all here for you. I will send you a bunch of resources. I can answer any questions you have, or you can comment below and I can do that too. So let's get started. To begin with, when you apply, you will choose a time to interview. And in your interview, VIPKID wants you to pull out all the stops. So everybody's like, oh my gosh, I got to buy all this stuff. No, you don't have to buy everything under the sun. But there are certain things that they look for that makes you stand out and do a lot better in your interview. And one of those things is they want to see a background behind you. Now, this is a dry erase board I bought. You don't have to go buy anything. Just hang something on the wall. Or if you want to buy something, go get one of those oil drip pans. It looks like a massive cookie sheet. Or you can even use a cookie sheet and hang behind you so it's magnetic. Some people paint theirs. Some people cover theirs with cloth. You do what you want. Wrap it in wrapping paper. Do whatever suits your fancy. But put something behind you that looks educational and you don't have to go crazy. I went to Dollar Tree and just got those bulletin board borders that were like ABCs and I still have them. In fact, they're down here on the floor behind me, but I had that cover my whole board, and then I had a little corner left to put my teacher sign, and you can see this on Instagram. And then my husband went and got me a piece of sheet metal from Lowe's, and he mounted it to like this rolly cart thing so I could move it around the classroom and change spots when I needed to, or move things away when we had a guest staying in our guest room. I've since taken that down. It was just too complicated. I got to where I wanted something much simpler like this. So that's what I'm, and I love magnetizing everything that I have. So you don't have to go magnetic. That's just me. And just put something behind you educational, something fun, and then have your name. I have B-E-J because there's more than one Teacher Lauren at VIPKID, but just make you a little sign. This is cardstock and stickers from Target. Teacher Lauren, whatever your first name is. And then avoid world maps because parents and sometimes VIPKID staff get offended by the way China and the outlying islands are represented, so just be aware that there could be drama. Just avoid it. I'm an avoider. You can definitely do a U.S. map, but just don't go there. Some people just get a shower curtain hang behind them. You don't have to go fancy, or a science folding board. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm shaking you. Oh, no. Sorry. You can use a science folding board and just pin things to it, whatever you think, whatever suits your fancy. Also, you will teach a lesson. So when you interview, they will ask you typical interview questions, and then they're going to say, okay, I will pretend to be a five-year-old who does not know English, and they will email you links that are like PowerPoint slides they want you to learn because you're going to teach that. And in that lesson, you want to only give like 1 minute per slide. Or if it's like a five-minute teaching session, only give however many slides there are, divide that up so you don't go over your time, because you only teach for like 25 minutes at a time anyway in a normal class, and they want to see you be able to cover the material to use 2D and 3D props. So here's what I recommend. Go to Dollar Tree and find these little balls that have a face on them and purchase those and these toy balls. These will come in handy because there's a lesson on toys. There's a lesson on feelings. They keep changing this, so it might be different now, but that's what it usually is. And what you can do is hold this up and say, I feel angry or mad, whatever it is. They also have these huge cards that say, I feel, and I found these on Amazon, and they have happy, sad, mad, excited, all those good things. Whatever you do, if you get these and you get this ball, do not say silly. It translates to stupid. I feel stupid. You don't want to do it. And don't, in your little paragraph you write about yourself, don't say I'm a silly teacher. It doesn't look good. Don't do that. Also, look for food props. These are little erasers I got at Dollar Tree that are pizzas and burgers and ice cream. Milk, cookie, eggs, cake comes up often. Birthday things come up often. So I have like a cheap little, I'll show you, a little balloon I saved for my husband's birthday one year that I hold up. And then there's die-cut cutouts. There's like a whole teacher section of this stuff. And then go down the toy aisle and you'll find even more. Just fun things like that, because you will see that in every lesson. Animals come up at every level, every lesson. So investing in that will invest in your future with VIP Kid in a way. Don't go crazy and go broke, but just find a few like animals. They have dollhouse furniture. I found this at Dollar Tree, and I use this when I teach level two, my home, and little family things that show mom, dad, brother, sister, grandma, grandpa. You'll see that a lot. And then find something that when you teach a little one, when you come on screen, will help them warm up to the screen. So, for example, I hold up Mickey. Like, if they just stare at me and they're just like, I don't know, I'll go, are you happy? And they're like, yeah, Mickey. You know, like, oh, they get excited. You can find things at Dollar Tree for that too. I found him on Amazon. I figured everybody knows Mickey. Everybody kept swearing by having Marshall from Paw Patrol, but not everybody knows Paw Patrol. So I went with Mickey. All that to say, find something to connect with your students. Have 3D props, but also get you a dry erase board. And I have one here that is a double-sided magnetic one that I found on Amazon. Again, everything will be linked below with my Amazon affiliate link. But you don't have to do that. You can go to Dollar Tree. There's tons of dry erase boards to pick from. I recommend getting the fat markers, dry erase markers like these. Not that one, though. Go with the darker, more bold colors like reds, greens, blues, and blacks, because they show up better and the fatter ones show up better. The skinny ones don't show up well. What else do you need? 2D props. So like little flashcards that you can find at Dollar Tree as well really do come in handy. I find little animals sometimes. And then these little dice come really in handy. I say handy a lot because they expect you to have a reward system. Every lesson has a reward system built in, and some are interactive where you can move things. Definitely use that in the interview. Teach them to do drag and drop, drag and drop, and use a mouse and drag and drop. But they want to see you have an outside reward system, because built into the lesson are 5 little stars at the top that you will gradually give them throughout the lesson to reward them and keep them motivated, and they want to see you do that. So take however many slides, split it up with 5 stars, and do your time split up, and then go, okay, I need a reward. Well, this came from Dollar Tree. So for your reward in your interview, draw a T-chart like this. Write Teacher Lauren and then put student or whatever your interviewer's name is on the top. And then go, I get a number, you get a number. Whoever has the greater or bigger number wins. And that way you can play a game and you toss the dice toward the camera and go, I get, and you draw the number and then toss it again. You get, and if you have the lesson with toys, the word throw will come up as a vocabulary word. So I throw, it'll come on play and all that good stuff. You could do this. There's also a cell phone printout, and you'll see on my Instagram if you look there, of a cell phone printout. There's a cell phone printout hanging up on my background. And then there's little emojis that I printed out, and it came from a Facebook group of VIP Kid teachers that created this. And I printed those out, laminated them, and magnetized them, and then I just hold them up to the camera. Like, it'll be time to give a star, so I'll go, you get an emoji, and then I make whatever face it is, and I go, and then I'll say, can you? And I'll point, and they'll try to go, and then we get a giggle out of it, stick it to the cell phone, star, boom, move on. Keep it rolling. There's so many other reward ideas, but those two work with every age, every level, everything, so it's great to use in your interview. So we've covered 2D, 3D props, a reward system, something to warm up the student. You will also need a microphone, and sometimes my daughter steals mine, and sometimes I end up with it all over the place. This is my microphone from Amazon. It lights up, it talks, it records. kids love this. Some teachers just use a toilet paper DIY roll that they make with glitter and all the good stuff. I don't have enough patience or time for that right now. So I found this bad boy on Amazon, and I will do my best to link him below. And if anything I've mentioned is not linked below, please let me know. And I will gladly send that to you so that way you can find that easily. Don't go broke, though. Just have at least that much. A lot of people swear by having a puppet because students will repeat the question instead of the answer because they don't know what's expected of them. And they're like, what is your name? Instead of my name is, they'll say, what is your name? And you're like, what is your name? And they're like, what is your name? So a lot of people say, take a puppet and go, I'm going to use my hand tonight because my puppet's way over there right now. Hi, Tiger. How are you? Pretending it's a tiger puppet. And then Tiger will say, I am happy. Oh, good, Tiger. Tiger, what is your name? My name is Tony the Tiger. Tony, nice to meet you. That way it shows them this is the response. And then you go, Leo, hi, what is your name? Something to that effect to show conversation. It has never worked well for me, obviously. But when I hold the microphone, I'll say, what is your name? Like I'm interviewing them, they get that. So the microphone works better for me, but some people swear by having a puppet. I don't know. I don't know. And encourage the student. Do high fives every so often. Be excited and animated in the interview. But if that's not you, that's fine. You don't have to do that. They just tend to like that more and more smiles. And then when you go on to teach, do your own version, whatever you want to do. If you don't want to do any props, there's teachers that are minimalist out there. I've had parents say they prefer props, so that's what I'm doing. And I prefer visuals, so that's what I do. So you've got your background, your teacher sign, microphone, dry erase board, 2D, 3D props. And I think that covers it. Reward system. I'm trying to think what else you might need that they're looking for. Make sure when you see a vocabulary word that's lit up in red or orange, you get to the slide, you underline that word, say the word slowly, cup your ear. This is TPR. And if you're looking for TPR tips, look up Nancy Taylor, VIPKID TPR tips. She has all the things for TPR, synthetic phonics, reward systems and why we use them. Look her up for incidental language. Incidental language is like the extra words and fluff that you put into a sentence that then they have to translate and they may not know, they've never heard. So be careful using too much of that. And let's see, I believe that's all. Make sure you give those 5 stars and watch your time. This sounds crazy. You do this once and then you'll do it again. Sometimes it's live. Sometimes they let you record it and pretend like a student is there. Make sure you give time for the student to respond, to understand what you just said, allow for delay, and then them to respond. And do the vocabulary word at least twice. Some people say 3 times. I do it twice. It's fine. At least 2 times. And then do the whole sentence and they repeat the sentence after you. And you'll see that in Nancy's videos too. Feel free to ask any and all of the questions. I got you. Make sure you have a good headset, good lighting. Again, all that's linked below. You don't have to have the rig I have, but I got tired of putting bright light bulbs and having like 5 or 6 lamps around me to make it bright. Parents want bright lighting. So change your light bulbs out everywhere, make them bright. But if you want life to be easy, you can get my rig on Amazon. And I think it was like $40 or $50. Not that major, and I can travel with it, so it's pretty handy. Again, handy. Hope that was helpful. Make sure you message me or comment or send me an email letting me know if you have any questions or if you have not applied yet. Use my referral code or referral link and let me know so that I can help you at vipkidteacherlaurenbej@gmail.com. Thank you guys. I wish you all the best, and I'm so excited for you to join the VIP Kid family. You're gonna love it. It's going to make you crazy sometimes, and other times you're just going to be like, this is the best ever. That's most of the time. Have a good night. Goodbye.